I don't know if you can see that, but that there is very, very faint positive. I really, 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 really don't want to lose this one. I just don't want to go through it again. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know if there will be a baby at the end of this. It is the most exhausting thing to go through, to just be so worried all the time. I'm just really, really struggling. I'm just so, so nervous. So, so, so scared. In 2 days, I have my first scan. I've been in that scan room enough times and been given bad news. Just had a massive freak out. I don't know why, but I just want everything to be okay. I've literally never been so nervous about anything in my life. I really, really, really just want good news today. This is a heartbeat. It's still very early days. There was a little baby there with a yolk sac and a little heart beating. We're not out of the woods yet, but we're doing really well so far. I'm so happy.
It's been a month since I found out, since I took that test. It has gone on forever.
Got a bit of a bump going on now. I've got my scan tomorrow. I'm really, really nervous again. Everything's totally perfect. I saw the baby on the screen wiggling around and heard the heartbeat and saw the heartbeat and yeah, everything's totally fine. And I'm so relieved and I'm so happy and I feel so emotional. I got my first little pictures. I just feel like I'm just so excited. I'm so excited to meet this baby and I really feel like I can start to believe that that might happen now.
This should, hopefully, all being well, be my last ever appointment with the recurrent miscarriage clinic.
All right, so put your hands up then if you want mummy to have another baby.
They said I urgently need to see someone at the prematurity clinic. They're going to talk to me about putting stitches in my cervix. There's a risk of you going into premature labour or having a late miscarriage.
The baby.
It's been a very, very, very long few weeks. We are viable, and whatever happens, at least we're in with a fighting chance. My cervix isn't quite as strong as it should be. And then I started going bald. Yeah, it got worse. There it is. There it blows. Excited and getting impatient and just ready to meet this baby. It's Monday, I'm due on Wednesday. We've been at the hospital this morning in Harrogate to try and finalise a plan for the birth. Originally we were aiming for home birth. I've still got all the prep work done for that. I'm prepared if baby just decides to like ping out at some point. They checked my cervix today and it was looking very favourable. He did offer me a sweep, which I declined just because I don't have any childcare arranged. But I'm going back on Wednesday to have a sweep. See if that gets things moving. If not, then I'm booked in on Friday to have a balloon put up there, which is like a drug-free way of inducing things. They don't want to use the pessary on my cervix and they don't really want to give me the drip because it increases the risk of uterine rupture because I've had a C-section. So I don't know, he seemed pretty confident that things were going to happen soon. I've been overdue every time, even when it's looking like things are imminent. So I'm going to go in on my own. The spouse has got to wait at home till his mum gets here to look after the kids, so I'll go in, have my sweep. If things happen, then he can come in. If they don't, then hopefully they'll let me go home on Thursday, because it's my birthday, and go back on Friday. I just want this baby out now. 40 weeks today. It is the 28th of November, and it is my due date. I'm still pregnant. but I am heading into hospital shortly. They're going to keep me in overnight because Rufus's labour was so quick that they don't want to sweep me and then send me home to have a baby at the side of the road. So I don't know if it will work or not. I would suggest probably not. I've had lots of sweeps in the past that have never done anything. But I am actually sitting here having contractions as we speak. They're not massively painful, but they're very tight. They're quite... I can definitely feel the tightness and the pressure, and they're quite regular. Again, I've had a lot of these in the past that haven't led to anything, so I'm not getting my hopes up, but I don't need to leave for another hour or so to get to hospital, so I'm just going to sit here on my ball, keep bouncing and see if they progress into anything more. If they do, then I'll probably cancel my sweep and stay at home and fingers crossed have a nice home birth. If they don't, then I shall get in the car and go to hospital and have a nice vigorous sweep and hope that that might set things off overnight. And I'll have a lovely jubbly baby on my birthday tomorrow. Oh, oh, oh. So I'm just in a room on my own. Don't want them thinking I'm talking to myself, so but yeah, I've told the spouse not to bother coming because they tried to do a sweep and the damage to my cervix meant that they couldn't get in there. But they did find a lump up there, so then someone else came to check that. They think it's okay, it's just a cyst. It'll need looking at properly once the baby's out, but it's fine for now, it's not going to get in the way. And then he tried to do a sweep, couldn't do it, left, and then came back and said he'd spoken to my consultant that I saw on Monday, who had said he was definitely able to get into the cervix, so he said I'm going to try again. And did managed like a small sweep, couldn't quite get in there, but said he hopes that he's sort of aggravated things enough to get things moving. So yeah, I don't know, I'm very sore now. I've got a very 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 sore vagina. But yeah, I guess I'm just gonna read my book and eat some snacks, and they won't keep me in case things progress. They're gonna check me again in the morning. I guess if nothing's happening, then I'll go home and then potentially come back at the weekend to be induced. So we'll see. Baby, 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 oh, like baby, 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 no, like baby, 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 oh, I thought you'd always be mine, mine. Party when I was 13. My first love. There was nobody that compared to my baby. Okay. Not much is happening so far. I'm just watching on the slab. I couldn't get up or anything. I'm having contractions. And they are quite sore. But I just want to give it a bit longer before I go and tell someone, because I've had so much poking and prodding, it's probably just a result of that. So I've got a feeling that when I lie down and go to sleep, they'll just go. But if they don't, then this could be it. Really long night of Braxton Hicks. Like a few hours after my sweep, they got really strong. I had a bloody show and I thought
nothing's happening. And then they just sort of stopped. But they carried on like all night, but they just were sporadic and not very strong, so it's still in there. It's going to be a long day. Hopefully I can go home, because baby's clearly not coming out, so. And it's my birthday. I just want to go home, see my other babies, and eat some cake, and yeah. So I just had another consultant come and attempt a sweep, but my cervix is so badly scarred that it just won't open at all. So now there's the concern that they're not going to be able to get it to open, and that it won't open in labour. So the consultants are going to have a chat and make a plan and decide what is the safest way to get this baby out. So none of this is really going how I'd hoped or imagined, but you know what, as long as I get a healthy baby at the end of it, then it doesn't matter, does it? Let's just get it out and hope that it's okay.
What's the point of me being here?
So when you're born, in a few years' time, when you watch this video of your birth, that's how your dad felt about having to be here for it.
I'm only kidding. It's just very boring, mate. Hurry up.
So they've just tried to force my cervix open with some sort of...
Speculum?
No, they put the speculum in there, mm-hmm. And then something...
Forceps?
It wasn't forceps. Some sort of metal thing. Tried to break through.
Balloon.
It wasn't forceps. They tried to break through the scar tissue.
I want to break through.
And it didn't work. And it was agony.
Telling you, made a good meal out of it.
I didn't take my camera because I didn't think anything much was going to happen. But I'd say it was probably more interesting than labour. Because I was on the gas and air.
Tell
that stuff makes me... Anyway,
why did you cry?
I didn't cry. Can you shut the f*** up? Yeah, options now are to go to surgery and see if they can surgically open it, or have a C-section. So, they've gone to discuss it. I'm just waiting for them to come back and basically tell me what to do, because I can't make the decision. So. You alright there?
Just catching up on some sleep.
Don't overdo it, will you?
Well, very, very tired.
Waiting to go for a C-section. It's not ideal, but as long as we get the baby out all right, don't even care anymore. Just need it out now. Just tape top ears. Nice bald head. Ready to go. From this moment on,
from this moment, I have been. You could have shaved your legs.
I did. I've been in here 2 days, though. Ow!
Right.
No, next one. From this moment on,
sounds like a galloping horse. I can't wait to live my life with you. I can't wait to start. Daisy will be delighted.
I can't believe we've got four kids. That's so many.
Oh yes, and to the baby.
Daisy? Daisy?
Mummy!
I got something to show you.
Mummy!
Mummy!
Yeah.
It's a boy or a girl?
That is your new baby sister.
Dotty and Mummy,
happy birthday
to you.
I love you so.
to me, sweet as can be.
Oh, chop chop.